We created Swift with a clear goal of building a language that meets the challenges of modern development without trading off performance for safety. One that's powerful, but also easy to use. And today, we're taking that further with Swift 6.2. This release adds some great features focused on performance. One of the most anticipated is inline arrays. These allow you to declare arrays with a fixed size that can be stored on the stack or directly inside other type without using heap memory. Knowing the size of an array at compile time unlocks optimizations by the Swift compiler, enabling significant performance wins. We're also introducing a new span type. It provides a safe alternative to pointers for fast, direct access to contiguous memory. This type is key to another new feature that improves communication with unsafe languages like C. When C pointers are annotated with length and lifetime information, they can be bridged into Swift as a span, providing a memory-safe interface that's also easier to use. This combination of safety and performance makes Swift a great option where these attributes are critical. And that's why WebKit is introducing Swift into its codebase, making use of a new opt-in strict memory safety feature to make sure interaction with C APIs happens securely. We've also made improvements to C++ interoperability, with code written using more advanced C++ language features now callable from Swift. And beyond C, Swift's cross-language support has expanded, with packages for interfacing with Java and JavaScript code. And you can now run Swift in the browser. Working with the open source community, we've brought official toolchain support for WebAssembly to Swift 6.2. Next, let's talk about concurrency. For your app to be secure and stable, it's really important that your code is free from data races. The Swift 6 language mode is designed to make your concurrent code safer. In many cases, though, like your app's user interface or command line tools, you're actually writing code that's only ever meant to be single-threaded. Swift 6.2 makes it easier to write that single-threaded code. You can configure modules or individual files as running on the main actor by default without any additional annotations. It's also easier to make async calls from the main actor, with better language defaults that generate fewer compiler warnings for code that is not intended to be run in parallel. And when performing CPU-intensive tasks, you can offload tasks to the background to keep apps responsive with the new concurrent attribute. At Apple, we're using Swift everywhere. We run it embedded on the silicon that secures memory management on the GPU, and in large-scale server workloads like the Apple Password Service, which handles billions of requests a day from devices all over the world, and where a recent rewrite in Swift resulted in a huge reduction in server footprint. Many of you also develop cloud services for your apps. Reusing your app's Swift code in your server implementation is an exciting opportunity for you as an app developer. Like the team at Cultured Code, who use Swift to power the server-based synchronization of their award-winning task manager, Things. To streamline the development of these server-side components, we've created Containerization, a new framework and tool for containers. Its command line tool lets you create, download, and run Linux container images right on your Mac. And it's built on an open source framework that is optimized for Apple Silicon and provides secure isolation between container images. Containerization is written in Swift and it's available as open source today. You can download the binaries or check out the repo on GitHub. On the new swift.org website, you'll find guides for getting up and running writing cloud services in Swift, along with a new toolchain installer that makes using Swift on Linux easier than ever. We're excited about the future of Swift, wherever you use it.